welcome to the session. So today I'm here to introduce the last unit in the data structures, and this is the last data structure also we will discuss in this semester, that is graph. So in the earlier unit we have discussed about tree. So tree and graph both are nonlinear data structures. Okay, so but we are already implemented tree, why we want to go for graphs? What is the major importance of graph in the data structures? We will see right now. The first one, introduction. So in the introduction part, first we will discuss about what is a graph, why it is needed. What is a graph? Why it is needed? So in general, a graph is look like this. Say A is a one vertex, B is a one vertex, B is a one vertex. So simply we are connecting all the vertices with edges. This is a terminology. So in the latter part we will see in brief this terminology. So graph is like this. What is the major difference in between tree and graph is cycle. A graph consists of cycles. Tree doesn't consist any cycle. What it means of cycle? Cycle means the starting vertex and the ending vertex may be the same. It is a cycle. See here, I am traveling A to B, after that B to D, then D to C, then C to A. Means I am starting from A and I am ending also A. Nothing but it is a cycle. So in a tree, that is not possible. And in a tree, the starting node is called as root node, ending node is called as leaf node. These two are not same at any moment of the time. And one more importance of a graph, this is the difference in between tree and graph. Actually, what is the major need of a graph is, the graphs can be simulated with the real-time examples. Say for example, the real case example, real-time examples is, suppose we are moving to railway station, so they are given one large sheet. The sheet specifies that set of destinations like Vijayawada, Visakhapatnam, Vijayanagaram, Srikakulam, Orissa, Bhubaneswar. So these kind of destinations are there, and they are given what is the shortest path from one destination to other destination also. Means our India map can easily converted as a graph. All the cities are assumed as vertices. In between one city to another city, the distance, the roadway distance is called as h. In case of Google Maps also, whenever you are choosing a starting point and ending point, it shows a certain path. So how their map is converted into digital one is graph. Graph only. So that is the importance of graph nowadays. Not only the map situation, in case of networks also. In a, every college or in any software company, they are connected a set of systems with LAN cables that will be also identified as graph only. That will be also identified as graph only. And if you want to send the data from one node to another node in a shortest distance, you can apply graph algorithms also. You can apply graph algorithms also. So these are the two more advantages which are related to graph, and it specifies why are the graphs are useful. Why are the graphs useful? So the graphs are widely used in a model any situation where entities are things and related to each other in a place. In a place. So one major advantage is family of trees. whenever you want to connect a set of trees, family of trees, in which the number of nodes have an edge from parent to each other children. Parent children comes from the tree data structure terminology. Similarly, the transportation networks, what I told in previous, like bus stand or railway station or airport, whatever it is. So, in which nodes are airports, intersections, ports, etc. The edges can be airline flights and one-way roads, shipping routes, etc. Means all the transportation networks can be represented with graphs. The graphs are, you can easily simulate it as a vertex edges space. With this help, we can solve the transportation problems also. Okay? So, these are the contents which you want to learn in the unit 5. First thing, the basic concepts and representation of graphs. So these are the two major representations of graphs. One is HCNC matrix representation and another one is HCNC list representation. In previous also, the stack using array, stack using linked list. Queue using arrays, queue using linked list. Binary tree using arrays, binary tree using linked list. So whatever may be the data structure, each and every data structure you can represent with an array data structure and as well as linked list. So here matrix is another form of array, two dimensional array and linked list. Okay, and these are the two different type of traversal techniques. Means here you want to know what is the graph, how to read in a graph by using our program, and the next level is what are the major operations you can perform on this, like insertion, deletion, traversal. And at last you want to discuss about applications. What are the applications of the graph? So here, minimal spanning tree by using Prince and Kruskal's algorithm, and another one is this class shortest path algorithm, transitive closure and Warshall's algorithm. Right? So objective of this unit. So one objective is you want to create a graph ADT. How to create a graph ADT? Abstract data type. That is the one. And another one is applications, minimal spanning trees, single source shortest path problem, and all page shortest path problem. Single source shortest path problem is a Distraught algorithm. By the help of Distraught algorithm, we are finding the single source shortest path algorithm. And all page shortest path algorithm is Floyd Warshall algorithm. That is, by using Floyd Warshall algorithm, we are finding all page shortest path. And at last, minimal spanning trees, here Prince and Kruskal's algorithms are used. Next, what is the introduction of a graph? First, I am defining the graph. The graph can be defined in two different ways. Collection of vertices and edges is nothing but a graph. And the same way, the graph can be defined in a mathematical representation also. So a graph G, generally the graph is represented with G with respect to mathematical, so is defined as an order of set. So V represents set. Set means it refers a set of entities. So V represents set of vertices, E represents set of edges. The combination of vertices and edges is nothing but a graph. So you can write like this, G is equal to V, E, where V of G represents the set of vertices and E of G represents set of edges that are these vertices. Say for example, this is the graph. So in this graph, A is a vertex. What are the vertices? A is a vertex, B is a vertex, C is a vertex, D is a vertex, E is a vertex. That is what you want to represent here. A, B, C, D and E, V of G. And edges is nothing but A to B is a one edge. So A comma B is an edge. Next B to C is an edge. So B to C is an edge. Next A to D is an edge.
The next B to D is an edge. So B to D is an edge. Similarly, D to E is an edge. So D to E is an edge. And at last, C to E is also edge. C comma E is also edge. So the edges are representing like this.
Right. So, and at last, note that there are 5 vertices and 6 different edges. 6 different edges. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are 5 vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 edges. This is the way to define a graph. Next, what makes the difference in between the previous one and the present one? So, the previous one represents a undirected graph. You want to see right now one more time. See, here edge is like this. Means it doesn't represent any direction. Nothing but this kind of graphs are called as undirected graphs. Generally, the graphs are classified into 4 different categories. 4 different categories. One is undirected graph. Another one is directed graph. Okay, this is 2 classification. Here, when we are adding weights to this, means undirected weighted graph. Directed weighted graph means at the time the edge is associated with some number, the number is called weight. At the end of this session, I will explain what are the weighted graphs and unweighted graphs also. Right. So right now I want to discuss about directed graphs. Means here an edge is like this. Means it shows some direction. Based on the direction, what happens? What makes the change? The change is called here. A to B is an edge. Say for example, I am taken A is a one vertex, B is a one vertex, here an edge is like this. So in this case, A to B is an edge and B to A is also an edge. Sir, where you identified this kind of things? Whenever you are representing a graph with the adjacency matrix, you can clearly observe it. In case of directed graphs, we'll say like this. So A to B, some direction is there. So A to B is only edge. B to A, no edge. That makes the difference. So a graph can be directed or undirected. Here I told that undirected graph is there, directed graph is also there. Next. In an undirected graph, edges do not have any direction associated with them. Means like this. So, if an edge drawn between nodes A and B, then the nodes A and B travels A to B as and B to A. Means A to B you can move it and B to A also you can move. But, in a directed graph, edges from an ordered pair, and if there is any edge from A to B, then there is a path from A to B, but not from B to A. What I told here, the same thing I represented. Next, this is the graph terminology. These are the very, very important bits. The first one is, adjacent nodes are neighbors. Say for example, in the previous example, A. What are the adjacent vertices of A? A to B is an edge, so B is a neighbor vertex. A to D, D is also a neighbor vertex. So the adjacent vertices of A is B and D. Right? And the degree of a node. So the degree of a node is nothing but, say here A is there. A is connected with 2 vertices. The degree of A is 2. Very simple. The A is connected with 2 different vertices, so the degree of A is 2. And here one more term is also there, in degree and out degree. In directed graph only you are getting this kind of term. In degree means what are the incoming edges. Say for example A, like this one edge is there, such type of edges are called as incoming edges. How many incoming edges are there?
that many count is there for N degree.
And out degree means what are the outgoing edges from A.
That is called out degree.
Right. So connected graph means a graph is connected with all the vertices. All the vertices with the edges. That kind of graph is called as connected graph. Say, a graph is said to be connected if for any two vertices u, v.
In our example, majority of the terms, the definition you have to write like this only. U, v means it's a pair. Here, u is also a vertex, v is also a vertex.
Okay, so in v, there is a path from u to v. U to v, one path is there. That is to say that there are no isolated nodes.
No isolated nodes means,
say for example, a graph may like this, A, B, C. So A is one vertex, B is another vertex, C is another vertex.
This is a connected graph. No, this is not a connected graph.
Why? Because here C is an isolated vertex. C is not connected with A and C is not connected with B also.
Means that this is not a connected graph.
Right. Next, complete graph.
Complete graph means each and every vertex should be connected with all the vertices.
So a graph G is said to be a complete if all its nodes are fully connected. Means, that is, there is a path from one node to every other node in the graph. Means that this is a complete connected graph. Why? Because A is connected with B and A is connected with C. B is connected with A and B is connected with C. C is connected with A and C is connected with B.
So this is a complete graph.
Means every vertex is connected with other vertices. So this is a formula for this. Say a graph consists of n number of vertices. You want to say the graph is said to be a complete graph. The graph should be consist n into n minus 1 by 2 edges. Generally in a connected graph, n number of vertices are there, n minus 1 edges are enough to say it is a connected graph. In case of complete graph, n into n minus 1 by 2 edges should be there. These are also bits. Next, other terminology, out degree of a node. I told that outgoing edges are coming into the category of out degree. In degree of a node, incoming edges are coming to the category of in degree.
Next, degree of a node. The degree of a node can be simply defined as in degree plus out degree.
So, in degree plus out degree. Next, isolated vertex.
Previously I told, a vertex should not be connected with any other vertex with the edge. The kind of vertices are called as isolated vertex.
A vertex with the degree 0. This is another way we can define. Degree 0 means no incoming edges, no outgoing edges. Means the graph, in a graph, that vertex not connected with any other vertex. Means isolated vertex.
Next, pendant vertex.
So pendant vertex is also known as leaf vertex. Means a vertex with degree 1.
Means it connected with only one vertex.
Next, curved vertex. A vertex which when deleted would disconnect the remaining graph. Means that here degree is 1. Whenever we are removing that edge, the vertex should be isolated. That kind of vertices are called as cut vertices.
Right.
Next, sink. These are all comes into the category of graph terminology only. Sink. So a node U is known as a sink if it has a positive in degree but zero out degree. Positive in degree, zero out degree means a graph having in degree value only but no out degree value. That kind of are called as sink.
Reachability means that connected.
So a node V is said to be reachable from node U if and only if there exists path from node U to node V. Means U to V there is an edge, then only you can say V is reachable to U. Means it's another meaning of connected. Strongly connected, directed graph. Means complete graph. Every vertex should be connected with remaining all the vertices with edges. That kind of graph is called a strongly connected graph. Unilaterally connected graph means a digraph is said to be a unilaterally connected if there exists a path between any pair of the nodes U to V, G such that there is a path from U to V or a path from V to U, but not both. Nothing but connected graph. Nothing but connected graph. This is a complete graph, this is a connected graph. Means each and every vertex to other vertex, there is an edge. U to V is an edge. V to U, there is no edge. No problem. It's unilaterally connected. Means uni means connected with only one edge. That is the case. Next, weakly connected digraph. Weakly connected digraph is nothing but whenever we want to remove one particular vertex or an edge, the graph is divided into two or more graphs. Such kind of graphs are called as weakly connected graphs. The same thing here also, a directed graph. Sometimes the directed graph is also called as digraph. A directed graph is said to be weakly connected if it is connected by ignoring the direct of edges. That is, in such a graph, if it is possible to reach any node from any other node by traversing the edges in any direction. The nodes in a weakly connected directed graph must have either out degree or in degree of at least one, not both. Biconnected components. Biconnected components means whenever we are removing one vertex, the graph is divided into two or more subgraphs. Those are all parts are called as biconnected components. The removing vertex is called as articulation point. So a vertex of G is called as an articulation point. If removing V along with the edges incident on V results in a graph has at least two connected components, that is called biconnected components. Say for example, A is a one vertex, B is a one vertex, C is a one vertex, we are connected like this. Say here, D is a one vertex, E is also one vertex like this. Whenever I am removing B, means B is articulation point. So, at the time, A to C is a one graph, D to E is also one graph. Means these two are called as connected components. Right? The next, we are moving to representation of graphs. Representation of graphs. So, I already explained at the time of explaining the unit contents. So, two kinds of representations are there. One is sequential representation, or in another way you can call it as adjacency matrix. Another one is linked representation. This is called adjacency list. And the modified version of adjacency list is also called as adjacency multilist. Actually, this is not in your syllabus, but this is also one kind of representation. This is also one kind of representation. Say, while moving to the adjacency matrix representation, say this is a graph. What kind of graph it is? Digraph. Or you can say, you can call it as a directed graph. Directed graph. First, what are the vertices? How can you say it is a directed graph? Each and every edge associated with certain direction. That's why we are called it as directed graph or digraph. Right. So, how to represent an adjacency matrix representation? The vertices are assigned to each and every row and each and every column. That's why here I am writing A, B, C, D, E. Similarly, A, B, C, D, E. Here A to A, there is no edge. Zero.
So edge is there, represented with 1. Edge is not there, represented with 0.
So here 0, no edge. A to B, edge. B to A, no edge. B to A, no edge. Similarly, A to C, no edge. A to D, edge.
So like that, an edge is associated with source vertex to destination vertex. They are represented as 1.
Right? So this is a 1 extensive vertex representation. This is directed graph with loops. Directed graph with loops. Loops is nothing but what? C to D, D to C. Means at the time what happens. So C to D is an edge. D to C is also edge.
Right.
Next, this is an undirected graph. Why I am calling undirected graph? No direction. In this case, A to B, edge. B to A is also edge.
Nothing but duplicate edges you are getting.
Similarly, weighted graph. A to B, 4 is a weight. So at the time, they are representing not 0, 1. Edge is not there, 0.
Edge is existed, it represents only a positive integer. The integer represents weight of the edge. That is nothing but weighted graph. That is nothing but weighted graph.
Right. So unweighted graphs consists of either 0 or 1. Weighted graph consists of either 0 or non-zero value. Now non-zero value represents weight of the edge. So this is the extensive matrix representation. Similarly, extensive list representation. We know about linked list. So how to represent the extent vertices with the list? Okay, so here A to B is a extent vertex. That's why A to B. A to C is also connected. That's why C is also a length vertex. Similarly, B is connected with C. That's why C. B is connected with D. That's why D is also extent vertex. Like C. C is connected with D. That's why only D. What is the cross mark? Null. Null represents the end of the list. Next, D is connected with A and B. So this is the last node. That's why you are representing it. So this is directed graph. This is undirected graph. In the undirected graph also, A to B is an edge, B to A is an edge. Means duplicate nodes. Next, weighted graph. A to B, here one more value is there. In each and every node, apart from the data, weight is also associated with the node. This is about XNC list representation. This is about XNC list representation. So finally, I am concluding that in the today's session, we are discussing about, first, I am introducing a very interesting data structure, that is graph. What is the need of a graph also, I explain. And what are the real-time examples for the graph also, I explain. So here, why it is needed and what are the applications in real time. I explain. Next, in the second one, the graph definition given. After that, types of graphs also explained. What are the types of graphs? Directed graph, undirected graph. Whenever we are assigning weights also, directed unweighted graph, directed weighted graph. Undirected unweighted graph, undirected weighted graph. Means four types. Right? So here I am representing, one is digraph, nothing but directed graph. Another one is undirected graph. Undirected graphs. Third one, we are representing graph terminology. Means what are the technical terms while knowing the concept of graph, like degree of a graph, degree of a node, in degree, out degree, what are the edges and vertices, sink, connected graph, strongly connected graph, weakly connected graph. These are all called as terminology. Fourth and last one is representation of graphs. Representation of graphs. So the graphs are represented in two different ways. One is HNC matrix representation. One is HNC matrix representation. And another one is HNC list representation. HNC matrix representation and HNC list representation. So in the next class, we are discussing about how to read a graph and how to travel each and every vertex in a graph. Nothing but graph traverses. We want to discuss that. Thank you.